Hello everyone. Myself Sakshar Shah. I'm an assistant professor from the Department of Pharmaceutical Technology, JIS University. Welcoming all of you to my first video of my YouTube channel, Pharmacy Guide. So before you move on to my video, I'll request all of you to please subscribe my channel. I'll keep updating different videos depending on, you know, different topics of pharmacology. I'm sure you will understand that, and if you have any feedback on this, you can put it in the comment section, and you can also like it if you actually like it. If you don't, you can click that like button as well. And I'll request all of you to subscribe my channel because it will keep you updating about the upcoming videos as well. So today's topic, which I'm going to start, and that's a very, very interesting, very important topic in case of pharmacology, in case of research, that is cell culture. So what is cell culture, and so today I'll be discussing about the basics of cell culture, not the details. So our topic, today's topic will be basics of cell culture. So the way of teaching, the method of teaching I'll be taking, like I personally prefer blackboard teaching or whiteboard teaching, what you can say, that I think if I write in a whiteboard and if I try to explain in my own words, I'm sure that will also be very easy for you to understand. I don't prefer, you know, giving a presentation and then explaining it, because I personally don't understand in that, you know, understand whenever that way the teaching is being done. So it's my personal preference of teaching in a whiteboard or blackboard. I hope you like it. You can definitely comment on that in the comment section as well. So what is cell culture? So firstly, we will go by the word. So first word we are having, that is cell. Cell, what is cell? All of we know, but culture. Culture means we are dealing with that, right? Cell is the, you know, smallest component or one of the small component in our body which is encoding the different functions, which is having the genes, which is having the DNA inside it, and which is basically encoding something. Our epithelial cell is having a particular function, a different type of cell is having a different function. So every cell denotes something. So whenever we are culturing, we are dealing with that cell and we are trying to multiply or trying to proliferate that cell, that phenomenon becomes cell culture. And that should be, so you would say that in case of cancer, cell proliferation takes place. So is that a cell culture? No. So the point in the case of cell culture will be, outside the body, developing cells in lumbar. So outside the body, so you are taking out a cell from a particular organ or particular organism. You are taking out it and you are culturing in a culture media. This media is called culture media. You are putting it in the culture media and you are letting it grow. That if there is one cell, if there is one cell, that will multiply into 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 16, and so on. So we have one, so we have to make it multiply. So whenever a baby is born, that is what? That is the internal cell culture, you would say. So cells are growing inside, cells are developing in number, and a, you know, full human body is being developed inside a body of a mother. So that is the thing, whenever we are dealing with that outside of our body, that can be called as a cell culture. So in case of cell culture, let me just tell you now, I'll be discussing about different points, different terminology which are very important in case of cell culture. So what are those? Firstly, the first terminology will be coming, that is primary
culture.
What is primary culture? So primary culture will be that culture from where, suppose, this is a culture plate, maybe, assume this is a culture plate. This is a culture plate. And here, log some cells are present. And we have taken it out from lung tissue. From lung tissue, we have taken few cells and allowed it to grow in the first culture. So here in the culture medium is present. So these are the culture medium. We let it grow. So whenever it is growing, but as there is, suppose in case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. There is 13 cells. Assuming there is 13 cells, we are letting it grow. So that could be 26 or into 2 or into 2. In this way it will grow. So this space is not sufficient to grow that much number of cells. What does that mean? Do we need a bigger space? No. What we will do is, from here, we'll take out some cells and again we'll prepare a culture medium. And from there, we will give some of the cells and we will let it grow in the same way. So this culture will become primary culture. This culture become primary culture, and this cell, assuming this cell will become the sub clone of this cell. Okay, so the cells which is present over here after growing will be the sub clone of the cells from primary culture. So the another terminology we have got, that is sub clone. Subclone is related to subculture. So the thing which we did, like from primary culture, we took out some of the cells and gave it to the secondary culture. It is called, I'm just writing in this way, secondary culture. That is becoming subculturing. So that is basically subculturing. And the cells present in the secondary culture from primary culture, so that becomes subclone of the first one. So I hope this, up to this, you have understood. So the next terminology what we going to study, that is cell line. So most of the time you have heard, or in, you know, if you are doing masters, then you will hear it during the time of your research, that is cell line. Cell line. So what is that? Cell line is being considered those cells from primary culture which is having high growth rate and it has all its characteristics and consists of all characteristics. So this is characteristics, I didn't write in full. So cell lines means those cells which are from primary culture. Okay, cell lines means those cells which are obtained from primary culture, what we showed here, that is from primary culture and which is having a high growth rate. So it will grow rapidly in the secondary culture. Okay, and it consists of all characteristics. That means that particular cell, the cell line should be having all type of characteristics of that particular organ from where it has taken. For an example, as we have mentioned earlier, if you are taking it from lungs or say heart or kidney, so if I am taking it from kidney and if that is the cell, so this particular cell should be having all characteristics of kidney or all characteristics of liver, that it should produce to help the insulin. And from where, from this cell, we can understand the level of insulin it can produce, or so on, because liver is the cell from where, from the islets of Langerhans, if we know that, from pancreas. So if it is pancreas, it's my fault, it should be pancreas. If we have taken it from pancreas, then we should know the level of insulin it can produce, the characteristics of insulin we can produce or that the cell can produce. So all these characteristics should be very much prominent in that cell. Then that cell can be called as a cell line of the particular cell. Okay, there are different human liver cell line. That means that cell line will denote, that cell line will develop a cell which is similar to human liver, and that will give you the exact characteristics of human liver. So if you want to do any kind of research experiment, which is a research experiment for an agent, you are thinking that it will be hepatoprotective, as in liver protective, and that drug should be, you would like to apply on humans. So what you need a cell which is from human, which is similar to human, and which should be having characteristics of liver, right? So that's why human liver cell line you need, that should come from human, and that should have the all characteristics of liver. Thus my drug can show a proper effect, and I can prove it as a hepatoprotective agent. So or cancer cell line, that means what? It can help to develop cancer cells. Thus you can apply your drug to which you are thinking it could be anti-cancer, it could be having anti-cancer effect. I think you understood my point. The next thing what we are going to study here, that cell strength. Cell strains are particularly those cells, there is not very big difference between cell lines and cell strains. Cell strain are those, that's obtained from the subpopulation of that particular cell line, which can be said, which is a mirror image of that cell line. Okay, so that cell strain should be having the all characteristics of the parent cell or the primary culture. Okay. So the next we will talk about the finite and continuous cell. Finite and continuous cell line. Finite and continuous cell line. So what is that? Finite and continuous cell line. Finite. Okay. So this means the cell line, finite means the cell line has a finite number of proliferative rate. That means finite cell line will grow. So if it is a finite cell, assume if it is a finite cell, that means has finite number of proliferative rate. So proliferative means growth rate. So it will grow, for an example, 5 times. Right? So 1, 2, it will become 2. 2, 2, it will become 4. 4, 2, it will become 8. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One, two, three, and 8 to become 16. So assume it is 4. So it is having a tendency of developing 4 times. So it will see 1, 2, 3, and 4. And at the end of 4 times proliferation, we are getting 16 number of cells. So that is finite cell. So it has a limitation to growth rate. But in case of continuous cell line, it is fully opposite of finite cell line. So initially it used to be, any cell line used to be finite cell line, but due to some external factors or due to some, you know, viral effect. So suppose your body has been infected with a virus. So your cells are rapidly growing. So that means the virus, due to the effect of virus or due to the presence of virus, finite cell has become continuous cell. So it is having no limit on growth, no limit on growth rate. So it will grow like a infinite times. Okay, there's a basic difference between finite and a continuous cell life. And now we'll talk about different culture conditions. Culture conditions means this denotes the environment which is highly required for cell development. So the temperature, the pH, the ingredient or the micro or macronutrients the particular culture should be having to give an optimum environment for the cell growth. So it is everything is required, like amino acids, carbohydrate, carbs, here oxygen, CO2, growth factor, pH, osmotic pressure, etc. These are the few parameters. These are the few parameters which is required in case of providing optimum culture environment for cell growth. Now we'll discuss about a very important terminology in case of cell growth. That is suspension cell and anchorage dependent cell. ANCHORAGE, anchorage dependent cell and suspension cell. What is the difference between two? Anchorage dependent cells, these are the type of cells which requires a solid support, and suspension, you understand, it does not need a solid support, it grows in liquid, like in suspension. So I'm just writing grows in suspending medium. it needs a solid support. Anchorage dependent means solid support dependent cell. That means that cells need a solid support at the back. So it will be in the solid surface and it will grow. So if it is a fully, suppose for an example, okay, this is a glass, okay, this is a glass, and here the cell culture medium is there. So if you are putting the cells here, so anchorage dependent cells won't be able to grow here, because here the medium is up to this point. Suppose here the medium, so here the cells are, here the cells are, so it will not be able to grow because it does not have a solid support, because it is in the liquid medium. But in case if this is a petri plate and this is a solid surface we are having, and here we are giving these cells, so it is getting a solid support behind its back, and as it is anchor is dependent cell, it will be able to grow. Okay, so most of the cells are anchorage dependent cells because that needs a solid support to grow, but less amount of cells are grows in suspension medium, so it is called suspension cells. So the next point is a very important terminology. I'm sure you have studied in your biochemistry, that is cryopreservation. CRYO preservation. Generally, it is written in a, there should not be any kind of hyphen, but I have given for your understanding. Cryopreservation means preservation, you are understanding. So, preservation of cells under a very critical temperature, very low temperature. And what is the temperature in case of cryopreservation? -130 degrees centigrade. So -130 degrees centigrade is the temperature for cryopreservation. At this temperature, to preserve the cell, thus all the characteristics of the cell should be preserved, and any characteristics of the cell should not be lost. That's why you can preserve any cell at -130 degrees centigrade with a proper medium. Thus, it will not be growing, it will not be destroying, it will be as it is, and you can use it later when it is required. So that is called cryopreservation. Okay. Okay, I'm so sorry. Next is, okay, one more thing I forgot to tell you. So, as I said, you have to give it, you have to put it in a particular, suppose there is a cell. So, you cannot only put the cell in a 130 degree centigrade. So, you need a medium. You need a solvent. So, what will that be? It can be DMSO or glycerol. It can be DMS or glycerol. So these are the solvent, or not solvent, I would say medium. Medium for these cells to hold, and then you have to put it in -130 degrees centigrade, and it will be cryopreserved, or it will be preserved without destroying itself. Okay? So the next thing that we are going to talk about morphology of cells in culture. Morphology of cells in culture. There are basically three types of cells. If we go through its morphology, and what are those? Let me just write it. So the cells which are in the cell culture, and let me just divide it according to the morphology, that could be fibroblastic, epithelial like, and the next one is lymphoblast. like cells. Fibroblasts are basically, okay, I'm just writing it here. Okay, let me just write it in a blue pen. These are bipolar or multipolar these are bipolar or multipolar these are anchorage dependent cell that is solid support dependent cell fibroblastic cells are bipolar or multipolar these are anchorage dependent cell anchorage dependent cell and elongated shapes elongated shapes so these are the three points under fibroblastic cells these are bipolar or multipolar in nature it is anchorage dependent cells that is it needs solid support it is elongated in shape so these cells are generally used to be like this whenever you will be seeing under the microscope you will be seeing this like this elongated and bipolar multipolar means there is a in the cells are middle and in its two side there is two types of ending okay so that is called bipolar or multipolar anchorage dependent that means it needs a solid support to grow and elongated in shape as you can see it is elongated in shape next coming epithelial like cells it is polygonal in shape polygonal in shape it is also anchorage dependent so it is polygonal in shape polygonal gonal means like this this is a polygonal structure so these cells are like this these cells are like this polygonal in nature and anchorage dependent cells anchorage dependent as in it needs a solid support to grow and lymphoblast like cells are basically spherical in nature in shape and it is a suspension cell so that means it is spherical in nature it is like round shape or spherical in nature and it is suspension cells that means it does not need a solid support to grow in a suspension it can grow so the first two type of cell like fibroblastic and epithelial cells is an anchorage dependent cell that means it needs a solid support to grow but this one the lymphoblastic cell does not need a solid support to grow so I hope you understood the difference between these three types of cells according to their morphology and the last thing now so as we are talking the basics of cell culture today so the last thing we will just go through we will definitely go through that later in a detailed view that is application of cell culture application of cell culture what that would be okay so firstly to know or to understand the application of cell culture you need to know what is cell culture what is the different facts related to cell culture so as you have understood the cell culture is a process to grow the cells under outside of your body under a suitable environment and you to study the cells and the effects of different drugs so as the I have said so first application will be to study drugs effectivity to study toxicity or to do toxicity study. In case of specifically carcinogenic or mutagenic effect, effect of any drug. To know the carcinogenic or mutagenic effect of any drug, we can go for cell culture. The very basic things, there are so many things that I am gonna discuss in the next class or so. So this was a very basic discussion about cell culture. There are so many things, like the equipments are there, the details of culture media is there, that definitely I'll cover in the next videos. So this was a very, very basic thing to know about. So I hope you liked it, or I hope you understood. If not, you can put that in the comment section and you can let me know what you are not understanding or what the else, you know, how do you want me to improve my videos. I'll try my level best, I cannot promise. So thank you so much for watching this, and please do like, share and subscribe this channel, and please do let me know in the comment section what are the different types of pharmacological topic you would like to know in a very simplest way. I'll try to, you know, elaborate those topics in a simple way that you can understand, that anybody can understand the basic knowledge. Okay, thank you so much. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.